right. So word on the street is 49ers are taking calls. I guess they're willing to talk to any NFL team in regards to moving Trey Lance. This is kind of interesting. There's many aspects to this that a lot of people don't understand, but yet it kind of makes sense, but also kind of doesn't. Let's break it down real quick. So I did a previous video a couple months ago about this entire subject. My thoughts are, why would the Niners want to move Trey Lance? I mean, back then, because I'm thinking Brock Purdy had surgery on his throwing elbow. Most likely, he might not even be ready for the start of the season. And even if he is ready, is he going to be 100%? Plus, there's like this, you know, the Niners traded up to get Trey Lance. They traded a lot to get him, and they picked him in the first round. Are they giving up? Are they trying to save face type of deal? My thoughts were, let Trey Lance start. Let Trey Lance start and Brock Purdy become 100% first. There's no quarterback controversy. You can just say he's not 100%. Trey Lance is going to start. Give Trey Lance 3-4 games, see where he's at. If he's not the guy, you will know by then. And then on top of that, Brock Purdy will be 100%. He will come in, start the game, game 4, game 5, whatever the case may be. If they're like 1-3, 2-2, whatever, and Trey doesn't look good, there'll be no issues. Trey, you know, everybody can just say, look, Brock was the man. He was waiting for him to be 100%. But in the meantime, you were also giving Trey Lance a shot to possibly be the man, you know, because you guys originally thought he was. So that's what I was fucking thinking they were going to do. However, it kind of makes sense, too, because if they did that, Trey Lance, and let him start, if he fucking sucked or he's just not the guy, your trade value of Trey Lance plummets. You ain't going to get shit for him. Nobody's going to want a guy who is not good, and they're not going to give you much of anything. So the Niners are somewhat in a dilemma. They're trying, I wouldn't even say they're trying to save face. They're trying to get as much as they can, I think, by doing this maneuver. So they believe in Brock Purdy. It feels, it's pretty safe to say they believe in Brock Purdy, that he's the guy going forward once he's 100% healthy. Or at this point, even if he's not 100% healthy, they believe he's the man going forward. I think the Niners leaked that shit out saying they're taking calls. They're, you know, seeing what they can get. And I think they're doing this, number one, is they can say, well, look, Trey was hurt. He's a great player. But, you know, they can tell every other team, any NFL team who's interested, we want both guys, but we can't start both guys. They can say that, you know, like, you know, Brock Purdy's just as good as Trey Lance, and Trey Lance just as good, but we can only go with one guy, and we feel like, you know, Brock Purdy fits our offensive scheme better. That's what they could technically say at the moment. There's not enough film on a guy to say he's horrible, NFL quarterback, so it kind of, in a sense, there's still some trade value for him. So I think I understand why the Niners are doing that. Because like I just said, if they let him play and he sucks, they're not going to get anything near a second round, a first round. Well, they're not going to get a first round for him at all, I don't believe anyways. But they're not going to get a second round, a third round. They're not going to get shit for him. So they're trying to save as much as they can capital-wise and get whatever they can at the moment. I think that's why they're doing that. And because I feel like they just don't think he's the guy. That's the only reason why. Otherwise, if you really believed in Trey Lance, that would have never even have leaked. And if it leaked, the GM, the coach would have been, fuck no, that shit ain't true. We're keeping Trey. Trey's our starter. Don't give a shit. Hopefully Brock Purdy comes back healthy. He'll be the backup. If not, they can compete for the job. Why don't they say that? They don't say that. And the reason being, because I don't think they believe he is the guy. And I think they're moving on. And not saying that Trey is a bad player, but I think they've figured that he might not be the guy in their system, the right guy for their system. And they believe Brock Purdy is the right guy for their system. So I think that is the case at the moment. They're trying to get as much draft capital, or they're just putting a feeler out there just to see what teams are willing to give up for Trey Lance at the moment. So it's super interesting. I wouldn't say it's like, you know, it's a controversy of any sorts at the moment. And then on top of that, you know, obviously having Brock Purdy still on the rookie contract to get an extra year and a half of him, of having him at cheap. So it really makes sense, especially when they saw what Brock can do, and they believe in him. And so, like I said, try to get as much as they can of him now before he gets on the field. Number one, he could re-injure himself. Number two, he could play like shit. So either one of those two happens, most likely they'll get like a fifth, sixth, seventh round draft pick for him at best, if that is the case. But if, you know, granted, if he came in and started and he succeeded and was really good for the Niners, then you'll have a quarterback controversy when Brock is 100%. But that's the thing. I don't think they believe in him that well that they're going to think he's going to be the main guy to go to. So it's interesting that they're doing this right before the draft. And, you know, I want to see what the Niners are going to do on draft night now. I want to see if this is going to even gain any more steam that it already has. So I love the NFL. Offseason is still freaking exciting as hell. You still got shit like this to talk about, guys. So there you guys go. If you guys like this shit, subscribe.